What a difference 9 years make. I'm SE Cupp. Welcome to Unfiltered. Back in August of 2012, at the Amalie Arena in Tampa, Florida, the Republican nominee for president was greeted with thunderous applause. Mitt Romney, the former governor of Massachusetts, had secured the nomination back in May, beating out top hopefuls Rick Santorum, Newt Gingrich, and Ron Paul. Of course, he would go on to lose to Barack Obama, but cut to Saturday, May 1st, 2021. This weekend, now Senator Romney was booed by the 2,100 Republican delegates at the Maverick Center in West Valley City, Utah. "Aren't you embarrassed?" Romney asked his fellow Republicans, but alas, they were not. Romney's cardinal sin, of course, voting to convict Donald Trump in two impeachment trials earlier this year, meant he deserved it, I guess, no longer a loyal servant of the Trump-addicted right wing. He only narrowly avoided being censured at the state convention on Saturday. Of course, this was not Romney's first run-in with the disapproving and distrusting far right. Romney is, in fact, a central figure in the story of how we got here, to a Republican Party that's been co-opted by Trump and rejects anyone who doesn't obsequiously approve. His treatment by the far right, and maybe even more importantly, his treatment by the left, are important chapters in our political history. We'd do well to look back at them. So let's. Romney is not the main character in the story of how we got here. Of course, we know who that is. But he's clearly got a supporting role and a recurring one. Since 2008, when Romney first ran for president, he's been a polarizing figure inside the GOP, something of a bellwether for where the party was going, or maybe a canary in the coal mine. Seen as too moderate an establishment for the Tea Party set, plenty of Republican voters believed that he was the guy for the biggest job, that he should be the future of the party. He'd have to wait his turn behind John McCain in 2008. By 2012, winning the nomination did not come easily, with bitterly divided factions pushing for the more socially conservative Santorum, the more antagonistic Gingrich, or the fringier Paul. Like I said, he lost that general to Obama, but he would rise again, next time in 2016, as a potential candidate for Secretary of State in Trump's cabinet. And again in 2018, when he became a U.S. Senator. That election, perhaps his most consequential, made him one of the few relevant voices of the Republican resistance to Trump, joining Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger and Wyoming Congresswoman Liz Cheney. Now, Romney's not up for re-election until 2024, which means he's got plenty more time to ruffle the feathers of the far right, a cause that might end up being futile. Now, the far right has turned Romney, a reliably conservative voter, into a traitor and a cuck, someone so anathema to Trumpism, he's booed by his own party in his own state. But what about the far left? What did Democrats and liberal media personalities turn Romney into? Well, I was there covering that 2012 campaign, and I can tell you firsthand they turned him into a monster, a literal dog-abusing, child-bullying, woman-hating monster. The attacks on Romney in that campaign were vicious and personal. It wasn't just his policies that were torn to shreds, but his character. Stories from prep school and missions and family summer vacations turned into smear campaigns. A response to a question about gender inequality at the workplace, in which Romney touted his own experience as governor and wanting to put more women in his cabinet, turned him into a sexist pig somehow. His binders full of women comment showed why, according to one Democratic strategist, women don't trust him and don't believe he has their back. Romney's wife, Anne, wasn't spared either for daring to talk about the economy's toll on women. She was abruptly put in her place by another Democratic strategist who said glibly of the mother of five, guess what? His wife has actually never worked a day in her life. Now, whatever you thought of Romney's policy proposals, the Romneys are inarguably decent, kind, moral people. The needless villainization of Romney was awful then, but it looks even worse now when comparing Romney to Trump. Romney is a good guy. But that treatment of Romney in 2012 primed Republican voters just a few years later for Trump in 2015. With a crowded field in the Republican primary, voters remembered 2012. Maybe they thought if the left could turn Romney into a monster, well, they'll do it to anyone, whomever we put up as our nominee. Jeb Bush, Ted Cruz, Marco Rubio, Scott Walker, you name it, he'll be a quote-unquote monster. So let's just give them a monster. And did they? Now, the left isn't responsible for Trump. Republican voters got him elected. They own Trump and all his ugliness. But Romney wasn't a monster, despite what many on the left told us in 2012. And Romney isn't a monster, despite what the far right is telling us today. He is, however, always somehow right there playing a role in the shaping of our political battles, for better or worse. Mitt Romney, he's either the future of the GOP or everything that's wrong with it. It's telling that Republicans and Democrats have thought both things over the years. That's it for me. See you next time.